At the kickoff event to the new Natural Track Luge season at Kutai, Austria, we meet motivated comebackers. Ladies hungry for success and cheerful two-seaters. These are the absolute highlights of a thrilling race weekend. In the picturesque Austrian winter sports resort of Kutai, the Natural Track Lugers begin the season with a really tough mission. To fight for World Cup glory on a 230 meter short, but very demanding track. And they have to compete not in just one, but in two energy-sapping heats in each qualification round. The most demanding thing is the mental aspect, I think. You always face a new opponent. Sometimes you're on the red track, then on the blue track. You have to adapt to each of the tracks, and they're very different. The next difficulty is that the riders start on command. A false start is punished with a devastating 1.5 second penalty. The decisive criteria are the start gate, which is not used at other races, the tight curves, the short and difficult track, and for sure, the extreme steepness of the curves. Some have grades of up to 30%. You can imagine an easier kickoff to the season for sure. But after the Kutai race, we'll all be fit and know what's coming up next. I like it. We've all come here with a queasy feeling. We're all a bit nervous because nobody knows where he stands. It's not possible to train for a parallel competition like this. The track is built by hand, and a parallel race like this is held only at the beginning of the season. And here are the favorites in the doubles category. Pignitter Clara, who dominated the World Cup in the previous year. Holzknecht Regensburger, who took second in the overall World Cup. And Egorov Popov, who finished third. But before we start with the races, let's talk to the vice champions from Austria, Christoph Regensburger and Dominik Holzknecht.
I'm Dominik Holzknecht.
Hi, I'm Christoph Regensburger, and we ride the Natural Track Luge World Cup in the doubles category together. Who is more of a speed junkie? That's me, I'd say. If we visit an amusement park in summer, Christoph's afraid of the rides, but on the luge, we're just about equal. Who tires more quickly when training endurance? Good question. We're pretty equal. We both have the same trouble with our endurance. Thank God we don't do endurance sports, but instead a kind of sport where you need good speed strength. Who loses sleep over the right luge setup? Yeah, we're sleepless in the evening. We're normally quite sure that the setup is perfect, but quite often we experience a disappointment the next day. What's Dominik's best excuse to miss a training session? Good question. Dominik has a lot of excuses if he doesn't want to train. For example, he'd say, my back aches today, or it's cold today, so let's skip the training. That's why I have to make sure that I always motivate him. Who's more organized? I am. The organizer, that's you, even though it's me who organizes everything. Well, I have to think a lot. Yes, but I do all the organizing. Because Christoph forgets things quite often. But together, we're successful. Who's Christoph's biggest sporting idol? Well, it's not you. And Dominik's biggest idol? Yeah, I think I'm Dominik's biggest idol. Kind of. Are you sure? But all kidding aside, it's time for the quarterfinals. Regensburger, Holzknecht and their rivals have to fight to qualify for the next round, and the tension is mounting. So here's the starting list for the quarterfinals. All favorites are still in the race. No surprises yet. We'll begin with the second heat of the quarters. In the first pairing, European Championship runners-up Schopf and Schopf meet the second-place team in the Junior World Championships, Jemchuk and Lenko. The Ukrainians are 1.5 seconds back after the first heat. Will they manage to catch the clever Austrians?
Andrei Demchuk and Miroslav Lenko have some trouble with the icy track in that second heat, too. No problem for the Schopf brothers. The Ukrainians are out in the quarterfinals. Surprisingly, Pozhnev and Lazarev from Russia were 1/17ths faster than Dominik Holzknecht and Christoph Regensburger in the first heat. And in the second heat, they again pull out all the stops. For the Austrians, though, it doesn't go smoothly. Ivan Pozhnev and Pavel Lazarev even extended their lead. The local heroes, who got second here in the previous year, are very disappointed. Alexander Egorov and Peter Popov are the next strong duo from Russia. But Brugler Angerer came in 1/24ths faster in the first heat. Will last year's third in the World Cup be able to show their class and catch the Austrians in the second heat? The Austrians give them a run for their money. They work the curves smoothly and pass the last difficult passage with flying colors. Brugler Angerer take it to the semis, while Egorov Popov takes sixth place in the end. Pignatar Clara are the clear favorites for the last quarterfinal. These exceptional athletes won the overall World Cup for the eighth time in the previous year. They are 1/61ths in the lead after the first run, an impossible task for their opponents. Kovshik and Tarasov from Russia risk a lot, but Pignatar and Clara take advantage of every inaccuracy of their rivals mercilessly. Stanislav Kovshik and Ilya Tarasov bow out of the race. And now, it's on to the semis. Christian and Andreas Schopf ride on the highest level today. They were 1/32ths faster than Pozhnev Lazarev in the first run. The Austrians are very motivated at the start and show a clean and fast ride, even in the difficult passages. For Pozhnev Lazarev, on the other side, it doesn't always go smoothly, and they don't reach the perfection of the Austrians, but the Russians still have the opportunity to fight for third place in the small final. And we'll see the Schopf brothers in the finals again. For Brugler Angerer, everything is at stake now as they are in the lead against serial winners Pignatar and Clara. They were 1/25ths faster in the first run and now have the big chance to throw the dominators out of the race. But the Italians never give up. In the last curve, they hit the perfect line. Pignatar and Clara take the lead, and at the finish line, they are even 1/41ths in front. A confident show by these technically brilliant losers. And now, the small final, the fight for third place. In the first run, Pozhnev and Lazarev took 1/22ths from Brugler and Angerer, but the Austrians start into the race aggressively and show a fine run in the upper section. Slowly, they close the gap on the Russians, and the last curve will decide over the win. This curve is a bit more difficult on the red track. It's very, very tight, but in the end, it's old hands Pavel Pozhnev and Ivan Lazarev who secure themselves the last place on the podium. A nice success for the war horses from Russia. And now for the finals. Will the Schopf brothers manage to take the win for the first time in 3 years? Pignatar Klaus' lead after the first run is tiny. It's only 2/100ths. Schopf and Schopf risk a lot, but their ride is not very smooth. Pignatar and Clara on the right track ride like they're on rails. And the two men from South Tyrol take victory once again. This is their 11th World Cup win in a row. They've been undefeated in 2 years. The race today was great, and it was also difficult, I must admit. We had an icy track yesterday, but today it got a bit warmer, and the track got more and more difficult. It was a tight race today, but we are really competitive. We showed our best runs in the finals again, and that ultimately decided the race today. Schopf and Schopf are very happy about second place, and Pozhnev Lazarev are also all smiles. Brugler Angerer missed the podium only by a narrow margin. Regensburger and Holzknecht have to work on their setup before the next race. The next morning, it's the singles turn. The track looks fine, and it's ladies first. Evelyn Langtaler dominated the previous season and took the overall World Cup. Greta Pingera got second. On third place but not competing this year, we had Russian natural track luge queen Ekaterina Lavrentieva. After winning the overall World Cup 12 times, and after a less successful previous season, she decided to call it quits for a year. Who will follow in her footsteps, and how will her absence change the ladies' field? We really miss her. She's always been a strong competitor. Everybody had the goal to be as fast as her. I ousted her last year, but who knows if I would be able to do that again this season. She's very lively and she always trains a lot. You could see that she was on a much higher level than many others on the track. I think she'll leave a huge void, as she really was an authority. She's the grande dame of natural track luging. On the other hand, the field will close the gap eventually, and there will be the next fast luger. I tip Evelyn. This season I have to defend everything, as I also took the World Championship 2 years ago. It'll be exciting to see if I can win the World Cup and the World Championship again. I would very much like to, and I've trained a lot for this. Evelyn's strongest competitor hails from her own team. Greta Pingera won last year's final World Cup race at Umhausen. This year I've planned to continue at the same point I finished last year, which was a victory. We'll see what happens. The World Championship is a big goal, but it's not my main goal this season. My main goal is to do well in the overall World Cup. It'll be exciting to see if the experienced riders will continue to reign or if the younger riders will be able to take over. Let's begin with ladies' quarterfinals. A Russian and a German try to break the phalanx of the Austrians and Italians. Svetlana Zarevina from Russia was dealt a difficult hand. She has to compete against Tina Unterberger. The Austrian rides extremely well today. She works out a lead of 1.14 seconds in the first heat. Zarevina is not able to keep up with the breathtaking speed of the parallel specialist. Unterberger flies over the ice and easily reaches the semifinals after this confident run. Svetlana Zarevina is out. She'll become seventh overall in the end. 20-year-old junior world champion Michelle Diepold is on a good way to establish herself in the senior field. She has a tiny lead of 12 hundredths over Sarah Bachmann from Italy. The Austrian rides very cleanly, but Bachmann is on her heels and doesn't give up. But in the end, Diepold takes the win and Bachmann takes fifth place. Diepold is over the moon. In the next round, she will meet her compatriot, Tina Unterberger. But first, we have overall World Cup winner Greta Pingera. She's half a second in front after the first heat against young German hopeful Theresa Maurer. Pingera has the better start, but Maurer isn't afraid to take risks and tries to catch up. She has some problems with her luge and crashes into the wall. Pingera advances to the semis with a strong performance, but on a more important note, Theresa Maurer reaches the finish line with a smile. That was close. Evelyn Langtaler from South Tyrol in the last quarterfinal. She's 42 hundredths in front. This should normally be enough for the reigning overall World Cup winner to take it to the semis. She tackles the task with her usual control and quickly finds her rhythm. On the other track, Maria Auer does less well and loses a lot of time in the lower part of the track. Langtaler easily advances to the next round while the Austrian Auer leaves the race after the quarterfinals. Next up, the semis. The first semi sees a duel of the Austrian team colleagues. It's Diepold versus Unterberger. Unterberger brings a lead of 30 hundredths into the second run. She's quick as always, but Michelle Diepold stays on her heels. Tina Unterberger answers with her key skills, riding tight. and steep curves smoothly. Depot doesn't fall back, but she's also not able to close the gap, and Unterberger can continue her mission to defend the title. Greta Pingarra is eager to win today, as we've heard before, but the reigning world and European champion wants to stop her from doing it. Langtaler is 23 hundredths in the lead. Pingarra has to risk everything, and she does well, riding very fast and absolutely clean. Langtaler is a bit less explosive in this run, and this is the consequence. Pingarra advances to the finals as she did 2 years ago. Langtaler fighting for bronze now. Now, everything's at stake for the women's finalists. In the small final, Evelyn Langtaler meets young Michelle Diepold. After the first run, Langtaler is only a tiny 300ths back. She starts with power, and both are neck and neck. None of them manages to break away, though, and neither makes a mistake. But Langtaler shows a textbook performance at the final curve, passing the finish line in front of the junior world champion. After second place in the previous year, Langtaler takes bronze this time, and Diepold proves that she can keep up with the senior elite. And now, the focus is on the final. Greta Pingarra was 900ths faster than Tina Unterberger in the first run. Unterberger with problems at the start, but she regains speed quickly again. Pingarra rides extremely dynamic, risking everything and still finding the perfect line, neck and neck. They rush through the final curves. Who will win in the end? It's Tina Unterberger. She's faster in the last curve and defends her title. Tina is overwhelmed with joy, winning a World Cup race for only the second time. She is now the queen of the parallel race. It's an unbelievably great feeling to win again this year. I think I've been in front in every run except for the first run of the finals, where I touched the wall in the last curve and damaged the spoiler. Fantastic confirmation. In the previous year, it just happened. Though it was on the horizon, it's really great that I was able to repeat last year's victory. Tina Unterberger is chuffed about winning 100 points for the World Cup ranking. The strong Italians Pingarra and Langtaler complete the podium. And now it's over to the men's finals. Patrick Pigneter won the overall World Cup for the 11th time consecutively the previous season. Alex Gruber took second ahead of Thomas Kammerlander. One familiar face was missing on last year's podium, though. The 27-year-old Austrian Michael Schickel had been third overall two times in the years before, but he suffered a bad injury that destroyed his season. Now, after an 11-month break, he's back, and this is his story. It was the first World Cup race, but unfortunately I crashed during training for the second race at Łódź. I broke my heel bone, and that was the end of the season for me. I've been doing this for 19 years, and this is my 20th season in Luging. I've never had to skip a race due to an injury before. It was the first time for me. It was completely new. I just had to keep quiet, and that was the worst thing of all. I knew I couldn't do anything to accelerate the healing process. I wasn't allowed to exercise. I felt trapped somehow. I just had to keep quiet. And that was the hardest thing of all for me back then. During the summer, Schickel took part in wheeled luge races. Did this help him with his comeback? Yes, especially mentally, because it was my first re-encounter with the luge. The movements are the same. The handling of the luge is not 100% the same, but it's quite similar. I noticed that I'm not yet ready to risk everything in some situations. But the feeling of sitting on the luge again, as well as of having fun, those feelings are back, and I can keep up with the others pretty well. That's the most important thing for me. It's key for me to catch up with the others in the first race. My main goal is the World Championship. I want to deliver my best performance of the season in February. The men's quarterfinals provide perfect conditions. It's considerably colder than at the doubles races, so we can look forward to some thrilling action. Last year's winner, Pigneter, is among the last eight men standing, just like local hero Kammerlander. Michael Schaikel won the qualification and came to the quarterfinals with a lot of self-confidence. But due to a mistake, Schaikel lost half a second to his rival, Georgi Bukin, in the first run. Schaikel has to risk everything now to close the huge gap. Even though Bukin is very fast, Schaikel comes closer and closer. How will Bukin take the difficult last curve? He touches the wall, but despite his mistake, he's still faster than Schaikel. The Austrian is disappointed, but he'll finish fifth in the end. Gruber versus Neurauter, the next quarterfinal. Neurauter is 24 hundredths back. Gruber rides risky as usual, but he miscalculates and touches the wall. He's not fazed, though, and rushes on. Neurauter can't capitalize on this opportunity. Despite the mistake in the upper part, the Italian is faster than Bernd Neurauter. Gruber is still not happy with his run, though. Now, Yuri Talik meets stellar athlete Patrick Pigneter. After the first run, he's only 7 hundredths in front. Pigneter takes the upper part, bursting with confidence. Talik's line is also very efficient, but then the Russian takes the curve too far on the outside, gambling away his chance to overtake Pigneter. The champion from South Tyrol advances to the next round after this clean run, while Talik is out of the quarterfinal. Thomas Kammerlander from the neighboring Ötztal Valley wants to show his good early form at his home race, but the third Russian in the quarters, Alexander Egorov, wants to stop him. Kammerlander is 24 hundredths in front and shines with his dynamic style. Egorov keeps at it, but Kammerlander doesn't let loose and takes his speed to the finish line. He loses his hand protector, but he's in the semifinals and Egorov begins the season with a sixth place. The men's first semifinal sees a duel between Italy and Russia. It's Gruber versus Bukin. Gruber is in front after run number one, but Bukin strikes back with a fantastic start. What follows is natural track luging at its best. Gruber and Bukin show a wild ride, regardless of the consequences. According to the motto, brakes are for losers. Alex Gruber loses this time, but he'll have another chance to make the podium in the small final. Grigory Bukin goes through for the win. And that is Thomas Kammerlander's goal as well. But he needs to kick Patrick Pigneter out of the race first. And Pigneter was 21 hundredths faster in the first run. Pigneter with a great start, but Kammerlander raises the pressure. He likes this demanding, edgy track. Pigneter shows the high art of luging, though, showing a calm and controlled performance. Lots of confidence there after his win in the doubles. He advances to the finals with his last run, and Thomas Kami Kammerlander on the other side will fight for bronze. Kammerlander competes with Alex Gruber, who is riding on the luge of his team member Florian Klar after his own sled broke. Still, he's 24 hundredths in front. Gruber doesn't perform as relentlessly as usual. Kammerlander takes advantage of that and comes very close. He masters the last curve skillfully and crosses the finish line ahead of Gruber. And he's relieved about his third place at his home race. Now the final. Grigory Bukin, who has reached a World Cup final for the first time in his career, versus the far more experienced Patrick Pigneter. The Italian is 25 hundredths in front. But Bukin is fast, and Pigneter can't afford to make any mistakes. The Russian is pushing, but Pigneter answers with control and efficiency. With a textbook line in the steep lower section, he defends his title, even though it's very tight. Grigory Bukin takes second place with an impressive performance, but Patrick Pigneter's tour de force outshines everything else. I'm very pleased I managed to win here again today. The Austrians have built the track so it fits perfectly for them, with the flat start and the tight curves. Normally, the Italians aren't very comfortable with tracks like this, and the Austrians had the opportunity to train here. Thomas Kammerlander takes third place while Grigori Bukin enjoys the podium for the very first time in his career. Patrick Pigneter celebrates his 44th World Cup win. This was the start into a thrilling season at the men's. So that's it from Kutai and the Natural Track Losers. We'll also be reporting from the upcoming race in Moscow with more exciting action to come.